How's it going? So in case you're just joining us, my name is Atousa, I'm a third year medical student, and I'm making a video every day in the month of November. For today's video, I wanted to talk to you about biomedical science. Now, this topic isn't new to my channel, but recently I came across this article that is literally titled "5 Clear-Cut Reasons Not to Study Biomedical Science." And obviously this caught my attention because prior to studying medicine, I studied an undergraduate in biomedical science. So when I came across this article and I had a little read through, I thought that there are a number of points that I want to discuss with you. Some of the points I agree with, a lot of it I don't agree with, and I think a lot of it is generally open to discussion. So I thought it might be quite interesting for me to go through this article, share some of the ideas with you, share with you some of my thoughts and my insights, and hopefully get you guys to share with me your experiences and what some of your thoughts are on some of the topics that I'm going to be mentioning. Okay, so I guess let's just get straight into the article, shall we? So this article was written around 2 years ago, and basically it starts off by giving a little bit of an overview of what biomedical science is and what universities teach it in the UK, etc. But then as you go down the article, you come up to a section that is called Misconceptions About Studying Biomedical Science. And basically what the article says is that there are a number of misconceptions that lead students to study biomedical science for the wrong reason. They will all be debunked once and for all in this article. Let's see, shall we? You have caught my attention, article. So I guess let's just go through some of these misconceptions. So the first misconception that they have mentioned is, you are guaranteed a job once you finish. This is what they've written. A biomedical science degree by no means guarantees you a job when you finish. It's just the first step to getting one. I imagine that's the same with most other degrees, but let's keep going. It seems many students enroll on the course purely because they are hoping to bank a job as a biomedical scientist right away. And I kind of get where they're coming from with this point. And if you haven't watched my video on IBMS accreditation, I would say perhaps go and watch that, because that might talk a little bit more about the difference between a biomedical scientist, the job, and the biomedical sciences, the degree course. But anyway, continuing on, what they've said is, students often pursue biomedical science as their way of still contributing to healthcare without having to undertake the many years in medical school. This is not a very feasible plan, as most UK universities offer a biomedical directed course, but only a handful are accredited by the Institute of Biomedical Science. So as I said, I have a lot of thoughts on this whole accreditation thing, because I'm a firm believer that not everybody who goes and studies a biomedical science course needs to have accreditation, because not all of those individuals are going to become biomedical scientists, the job role, who are going to be working in hospitals. You don't necessarily have to do that job role just because you've done a biomedical science degree. Anyway, they go on to say, that it's not very feasible because only a handful of UK universities are accredited by the IBMS. And then they go on to say, not to mention the supply of biomedical scientists by far exceed the demand, making it a hard industry to even find job openings. To give yourself the best chance, you will need to attend an IBMS accredited university and go down the full route of IBMS accreditation. Okay, so this is something that I get a lot of questions about, because I think a lot of students panic when they have an interest in biomed, but then they think, oh gosh, but not all universities are accredited, what am I going to do? While I completely agree that the job role of a biomedical scientist is quite saturated, and if you are 100% set that that's what you want to do, then perhaps going to an IBMS university will make that route easier for you. But like many students who aren't fully set on choosing their career when they're 18, it doesn't mean that you won't be able to pursue the jobs that you want to, even if it is a biomedical scientist, if you don't go to an accredited university. So I guess with regards to misconception number one, which was you're guaranteed a job once you finish, I see where they're coming from. I suppose just because you do this degree, it doesn't mean that you're going to have a job as a biomedical scientist lined up for you straight after. But I don't necessarily think that's a reason not to do biomed, because like many other degrees, it works in a similar way, that you're not necessarily guaranteed a job, but a degree will give you the tools and the experience in order to pursue your job or pursue a career. So The second misconception that they have listed, second biomedical science misconception, is that it is easier to get into medicine this way. This is what they've said. Many students use biomedical science as a route into medicine if, for example, they fell short of the entry requirements at an earlier stage. This is a feasible plan as many universities reserve places for graduates on their course to study alongside undergraduates. The misconception comes when students believe it is easier to gain access into medical school because of their knowledge of medicine. This, however, is not the case. Medical school universities prioritize A-level students and only leave a small number of spaces for graduates. So this point definitely has a lot of truth to it. I think sometimes it is tempting to think that, okay, just because I go and do a biomedical science degree, it's going to make it easier for me to literally walk into medicine. Assuming that you don't apply to specific grad courses and that you do an undergrad in biomed and then apply for an undergrad medicine course. So I guess I do have to agree with this point, especially because, and I can't remember off the top of my head which universities said this, but I think recently a lot of universities have said that even for postgraduate students, so let's say students who already have a degree in biomedical science, if you're applying to a medicine course with other undergrads, you still have to meet the A-level requirements, same as all of the other undergrads. So if, for example, you may think that I didn't do that well in my A-levels, but I had this extra degree, so it might help me get into a medical school, that doesn't apply to all cases. Certain universities certainly take into consideration the fact that you've had a previous degree and will favour you, but not all of them. So try not to get tripped up if this applies to you. The next thing that they've said as part of this misconception is that graduates are often competing against people with direct experience in healthcare, such as nurses or healthcare assistants. This makes them more value to the university than people who only hold degrees as they already have experience in a healthcare environment. So what they're saying there is that, let's say you do biomedical science and you want to transfer straight from biomedical science to medicine, you might not necessarily get favoured just because you have this undergraduate degree. But let's say that you spend some time working in a healthcare setting, that experience on top of your undergraduate degree will be more beneficial to the university, or will be more valuable, I should say. And that's what they've mentioned here. So I guess I do agree with that misconception to a degree. But obviously, different people's circumstances are different. And for a lot of people, and I include myself in this category, doing medicine as a graduate is so much more of a better option for me personally, just because I know I wouldn't have been ready at the age of 18 to start medicine. So the third misconception that they have mentioned is that biomed, it's like doing medicine, only easier. So this is quite funny to me. So they've written, even I was under the impression that biomedical science would be an easy degree. Why? Why would you be under that impression? I was seriously mistaken about the level of difficulty, and after talking with friends who studied medicine, I found that they were two completely different studying experiences. And I actually recently made a video talking about the differences between medicine and biomedical science. So I'm not going to talk too much about my views here because I've already made that video. But this is what they go on to say. Biomedical science students study the usual modules in medical school, such as hematology, human physiology, pathology, microbiology, etc. However, topics such as biochemistry are studied in far more depth than a medic would have to know. The extra knowledge that a biomedical science course demands often makes it difficult to endure. So yeah, again, I think I would agree that biomedical science isn't necessarily easier when it comes to the content. But again, I would agree with this point. And I don't know how much of a common misconception this is though. I don't know if a lot of people think that biomed is easier. From my own personal experience, when I was studying biomed during my undergrad and even when I'm studying medicine now, amongst my peers and my circle, there is a general consensus that biomedical science is more difficult in terms of the content, just because you tend to go into more detail about the complicated pathways. But perhaps that's just my experience, and there are other people who do believe that medicine is more difficult. But generally, I would say both of the courses have their strengths and their challenges, so take it all with a pinch of salt. So the next misconception that they have mentioned is biomedical science leaves the door open to many routes. This is the one that I had a lot of thoughts on. So they've said, if you play your cards right, you can certainly use biomedical science as a stepping stone into many things, but on its own, the degree has poor job prospects. See, that I disagree with. And let me read a little bit more about what this person has said, and I'll explain why I disagree with it. They have gone on to say, you can potentially become a biomedical scientist, but the supply is much higher than the demand, and you need to complete an IBMS certification portfolio to even be qualified enough for hire. So this is kind of building on the point that they mentioned earlier. You can study medicine, but the competition is higher and is roughly 10 times harder to gain admittance as a graduate. Conventional routes for jobs are often hyper-competitive, which leaves you with the prospect of changing fields and hoping your skills were transferable enough for an unrelated graduate job. So I do kind of disagree with this point, especially because they've mentioned here that you can certainly use biomedical science as a stepping stone to many things, but on its own, the degree has poor job prospects. I think the reason why you can look at biomed and think that it has poor job prospects is because, unlike medicine, where you know that if you study medicine, you become a doctor, with biomed, there is a much wider range. And because they've mentioned, again, the IBMS accreditation and biomedical scientist job, people sometimes get the impression that just because there aren't lots of biomedical scientist jobs, then the degree itself has poor job prospects. I think what I'm trying to say in a roundabout way is that if you think that just because you study a biomedical science degree, you're going to become a biomedical scientist, then yes, the job prospects are poor because there are limited job roles as a biomedical scientist, and not everybody who studies biomedical science wants to do that job role anyway. But let's just assume we take this away and we just have the people who want to go and study biomedical science. In terms of degree and job prospects, I would say that biomedical science has plenty of avenues you can go down. And I understand what they're saying about the fact that you may need to gain more experience here or there, but as a general consensus, I think that there are plenty of science-related roles that people can go into. And this is something that I wasn't aware of for the longest time, and I do have a video on my channel talking about a number of job roles that you can do with biomedical science that are in the field of science, that are in the field of healthcare and research. You just have to do the due diligence and take the time and try and find what these things are. And just to give you a personal anecdote, I remember when I was studying my biomedical science course, before I knew I wanted to go into research, before I knew I wanted to do medicine, I remember going to our careers advisor and saying, you know, I just don't know what jobs you can do with biomed. Like, there just doesn't seem like there are any jobs, because I had fallen into the exact same trap of thinking biomedical science, biomedical scientist, and nothing else, which that is not true at all. And I remember walking out of that career service very disheartened, because I think the person I was speaking to didn't have much knowledge about biomedical science. And her advice to me was, well, you can always go into business. You can always go into teaching. You can always go into medicine. And I remember as she was listing these things to me, I was thinking, well, you know, if I wanted to go into teaching or medicine or business, surely I would have done degrees more related to those, or actual degrees in those topics. And it was around that point that kind of sparked this thing in me of, no, there's got to be more. Like, just because I'm unaware of the numerous roles and things that you can get involved in within the biomedical science, within the research field, just because I'm unaware of them doesn't mean they don't exist. So again, if any of this applies to you, don't let that dishearten you. Watch my old video about the jobs that you can get with biomedical science, and I am going to make an updated version of that because I feel like I have a few more things to add to it. But also do your own research. And finally, this is their last misconception about biomedical science. They have written, I genuinely like learning about the human body, but I don't have good enough grades for medicine. They've written, if you were considering medicine, you'll most likely have knowledge in biology and chemistry. Have you ever considered studying biochemistry? This is a much more valuable degree, as your knowledge isn't scattered around the different topics in biology, but more focused on chemical processes and their relevance in biology. Again, I disagree with this point. They've written that job prospects are much broader and there is a lower chance of being stuck with a useless degree. I disagree with this because I think even if you study biomedical science, you can take biochemistry modules, you can take biophysics modules, you can take bioinformatics modules. And I actually think that will, I mean, if you're looking at it from the viewpoint of trying to get a job after a degree, surely that expands your toolkit, because let's say you're applying to a certain job role that may require more bioinformatics knowledge, you can say, well, I've done a module in this and I have the basic skills that I can build on. Or vice versa, let's say if you were applying to a biochemistry role, you can say, well, I haven't done a degree in biochemistry, but I've taken certain modules and I'll be able to use that information to build on. And I think going as far as saying that it is a useless degree, I think of all of the potential degrees that people could do, I don't think biomed is a useless degree. And maybe that's just a part of me that had such a positive experience with my course that I don't like the thought of people being disheartened or feeling jaded with biomed. But take everything I'm saying with a pinch of salt as well. Hopefully this video will be like a catalyst for you to start thinking about some of these things yourself and forming your own opinions on the matter. And finally, they've concluded the article with this summary. In summary, a biomedical science degree doesn't guarantee you free entry into a medical school, nor does it give you priority over A-level students. When picking a university degree to study, think less about job security, because nowadays, if you aren't studying medicine, which comes with its own issues, no degree you pick guarantees you a job after graduation. Think more about what you will excel in. Anything can be monetized as long as you're good at it. And yeah, I think that's a really, really nice summary. I completely agree. I think there are very, very few degrees nowadays where the degree will land you directly in a job role, and biomed is no exception. Anyway, my lovelies, I'm going to leave it there. I hope this has been some food for thought for you, and as I said, I'm making a video every day in November, so I will leave it there, and I will see you in tomorrow's video.